Good morning everyone and welcome to this class. This is class 6th, subject social science, chapter number 9 of civics, and the name of the chapter is urban livelihood. If you remember, chapter number 8 of civics we had covered, that was rural livelihood, in which we talked about the villages areas. How do the people, they get their earnings? There we talked that most of the people there in the rural areas, they are dependent on primary activities, especially agriculture. Here in this chapter, we'll talk about the urban livelihood, urban that is related to cities. So how do the people there in cities, they get their earnings and they fulfill their basic needs? So, urban livelihood means the different ways how do the people in the urban areas or in cities, they get their earning. And it's going to be our lecture number 1 of this chapter, urban livelihood. So, let's see the topics that we'll cover in this particular lecture. Topics to be discussed, introduction obviously we'll take. Then working on these streets, how do the people, they just work there in the streets and they get their livelihood, that we'll discuss. Then a cycle rickshaw puller, the person who pulls cycle rickshaw, how do that person get the livelihood, how do that person get the earning from morning till evening? That person works very hard. So about the life of a cycle rickshaw puller we'll discuss here. Then street vendors and hawkers, the people, the different sellers, those come there in the streets for selling different articles. So we'll discuss about them here. Then business persons, we'll take example of business persons also. And at last, homework will be there. So let's start the topics one by one. Before starting, one thing I want to tell you, this the complete chapter, basically two of the cousins, they are here and they are visiting different areas of city, and in the visit basically they are explaining all these means of livelihood there in the urban areas. So they went there in the street area, they talked about the vendors, they also talked about the business persons, and later on that we'll discuss in next lecture also, they went to the factory also and they talked about the person who worked there in the company, in the office you can say. So all these things, basically these two cousins, they are basically visiting to different areas and explaining about the livelihood there in the urban areas. Then, introduction. According to census 2011, there are near about 8,000 cities or towns in India. As in the previous lecture, I told you that the census means counting of people. And that is done there in India after every 10 years. So, according to census of 2011, there are near about 18,000 towns or cities in India, and people in urban areas are involved in different activities to get their livelihood. Clear? So here we'll discuss firstly the different economic activities that we had already discussed there in chapter number 8 also, when we talked about the rural livelihood. There we discussed all those economic activities. Now we'll take that again, that economic activities, primary activities, secondary activities, tertiary activities and quaternary activity. Primary activities. As in chapter 8, we did that most of the people there in the rural areas, in the villages, they are dependent on primary activities. These activities basically produce the raw material. Like we can take example of different crops, wheat, cotton, So cotton, that is the raw material for cloth. Wheat, that is raw material for different things like bread, biscuit we eat. Then we talk about the secondary activity. These activities, in secondary activities, the manufacturing work that is involved. The different things, those are made by using the raw material. Then tertiary activities. These activities basically involve the services. So, and the quaternary activities, they are recently added, and here basically the software that it is involved. So if you talk about the urban areas, most of the people, they are dependent on secondary tertiary activities. Clear? So we'll discuss here now that what type of different activities the people they are doing in this particular chapter, which two cousins they are explaining in the journey. Like, firstly, working on the street. They both firstly came there in the street and they talked about different people, those were working there on the street. People on the street doing different activities, like vegetable vendor was busy in arranging his vegetables like tomato, carrots, cucumbers, etc. So there the vegetable vendor that was present when they came there in the street, and that vendor was busy in arranging his different vegetables there. Then the stall of flowers was there just next to vegetable vendor. So one of the stall, it was there in on which the florist who was selling the different types of flower there. And then a person was selling newspaper, and cobbler was sitting under a tree with his tools there in a box. You might have seen that in different areas in the towns or the cities. The cobblers, they basically sit there on the roadside and they just use the mat. They sit on that mat and do the work. They all have the tools there in the box. So this complete scenario, what they had seen there in the street, they are explaining that these people, they are working there on the street. Then a woman with plastic items in a cart. They had seen one woman there who was having different items of plastic there. You can say mug or different other items, the tub, different items of plastic she was selling there. Then in one of the corner, rickshaw pullers were waiting for customers. There was rickshaw, you can just stand also, where different rickshaw pullers, they were waiting for the customers, that they will have the customer and they will take to the take those customers to their destination and get fare from them, the money from those customers. Clear? So this is complete scenario that they are explaining. When they came there in the street, they had seen different people working there, and they get their livelihood basically from these all work. Now we'll take example of one of the rickshaw puller. A cycle rickshaw puller, Bachu Manji, a rickshaw puller from Bihar. Basically, Bachu Manji, he belonged to Bihar, and basically there in Bihar, he was working as mason. Mason, the person who built houses, and there the masonry work that was not regular basically. So he came there in the city to get the livelihood, so that he can get for the his family, the money for his family. And he came there, he bought one of the old rickshaw. Then from morning till evening, he did the work for the complete day and just get the 80 rupees, 80 to 100 every day. And from that particular earning, he has to spend on the rent also, food also, and as well as he was sending that money to the family there in Bihar also. So here we'll discuss the condition of this rickshaw puller, how is getting the earning. He was working as mason in the village, but masonry work was not regular, so he came to city and bought an old rickshaw. Here he has become a cycle rickshaw puller. So this way he has become cycle rickshaw puller, that he came from village and he bought one of the old rickshaw. He used to take 5 to 10 per trip, 5 to 10 rupees basically per trip according to distance from customers. You might have seen that these rickshaw pullers, when we use these rickshaws, obviously they ask that I am going to take how much fare for that particular distance. So what is there? Bachu Manji was taking just 5 to 10 rupees per trip according to distance. If distance is less than 5, if more than 10. So, and he was basically taking the rides of approximately 6 kilometers. Then he earns 80 to 100 rupees every day. Out of it, he spent 50 to 60 on food and rent. And a large number of people work on street like Bachu Manji. So from 80 to 100 rupees, he spent 50 to 60 on his own, and rest he was sending there to the family there in Bihar. Even his wife there, she was also earning from agricultural work there. So this is the condition of a rickshaw puller that was working there. And there in the book, different short questions are given on different pages. So you complete those questions there only. Like, why did Bachu Manji come to the city? The reason, to get the earning. Why can't Bachu Manji live with his family? Because because the income that they were earning was not enough. That's why he came to the city. So in this way, some questions are there. You complete these questions. These are just basis of different case study that you are reading there. Now the next thing, vendors, hawkers. You know that the people who sells the different items there in the streets, they are vendors or hawkers. Now, a hawker is a person who goes place to place for selling goods. Clear? Now, if we talk about different changes there, these hawkers, they got some of the changes there. Like previously, hawkers were not allowed to sell their articles on streets. Clear? They were even some of the societies, they were not allowed to move there. But now hawking zones have been suggested for the hawkers to move freely, so that no foundation there in the hawking zones would be there for these hawkers. Now they have been made members of committees which think about their welfare. And some committees, those are made in those committees. These hawkers were made the members of those committees so that they can also talk about the welfare. So this is all about the hawkers. So if you talk about the people working there on the street, they are also venturing there from place to place. There a survey that has been given there, that survey of Ahmedabad city, in which it is seen that near about 12% of all the workers, they are working on the street. And these old workers, those are working on the street, they are not having any permanent shop. They are just having the temporary shops. Some of them, they just use mat, as we had taken example of cobbler. Clear? Some are having the carts there only. Those they just move from one place to another. And these old people, they do not have any worker or helper with them. They always do all the work on their own and with the help of their family member. Like if you take example of any person who is selling snacks there and moving from one place to another, that person basically get the all the things ready with him, just to in front of the customer, he just prepare it. The last touch you can say they give it. Otherwise, the material that they keep with them that is ready, that they basically make with the help of their family members. Now, marketplace. After this, from the street, they went to the marketplace. Who? From in the starting about whom we talked about? Two cousins. They went to the marketplace, and basically there they went there because one of them they had one appointment with dentist. So now there in the market they will discuss about the different shops they were there in the market and discuss about the business persons also there in the market. Like we went to the market, there were rows of shops selling different items. Here we are those two cousins. Okay, so they went to the market, then there were different rows of shops selling different items. You might have seen that in the on the marketplaces different type of shops they are present. Then we went to the dentist as my cousin had appointment with the dentist. Clear, as I told you in the from dentist clinic, she took me to the garment showroom. And this garment showroom basically in which we'll talk about the business persons. How do these business persons, they have their shop, permanent shops there, and how they arrange different materials for that garment showroom. Clear? So now let's take the example of business persons also. Business persons here, Harpreet and Vandana. These two business persons example that is given there. Harpreet's father worked in a small shop. Earlier, basically, they are talking about that Harpreet's father was working there in a small shop, and Vandana was a dress designer. So they both were working together now as owner of the showroom, the garment showroom here. Now they both opened the showroom. They buy different raw materials from different places. Like for the garment, why had they opened that garment showroom? Because this is the need of today. If we talk about the people in today's life, the people they prefer to get the ready-made clothes. So this is the reason that they opened the showroom basically. For that different clothes, they need to have the different materials for making the cloth. So here we are talking about that raw material by which they were preparing different dresses that they were arranging from different places. Even the different raw materials they were bringing from Mumbai, Ahmedabad, Ludhiana, Tripura, and some of the material from Noida, Gurgaon. So these are the some places, and sometimes from even the from foreign countries also. So they were arranging firstly the raw material for the dresses. Clear? Then after completion of the dresses, they do advertisement for the showroom in various newspapers, television, radio, etc. This is also one of the way that they were spending money on the advertisements also, that you know everyone about the advertisement because daily you are watching different shows, different serials there. In between the advertisement, they are coming. Advertisement to advertise to make the particular item popular among the customers so that they can attract towards that particular item. Then they are explaining that after then now where they had the showroom that was rented, but soon they are going to buy it. So they are explaining the condition of these business persons, Harpreet and Vandana. Clear? Now, like Harpreet and Vandana, Many other business persons run their shop there in the market. Many different business persons they are there in the market. And these all, they have different workers and helpers in their shops. Their shops are permanent. They get license from municipal corporation. Listen this very carefully. These business persons, they have the license with them from municipal corporation. When they start any of the business there, they have to take the license basically. And the municipal corporation, as we already talked, that the government there in the urban areas. Even the different these business persons, as they get the license, and second thing, this municipal corporation even decide on what day the market that remains closed. Like as the market that we are talking about here, it remains closed on Wednesday. So in different areas, different days are decided. Municipal corporation also decides that on what which day of the week the market remains closed. Clear? And this market about which we are talking here, that remains closed on Wednesday. So in that marketplace, not only the shops, different other services are also present, like banks, courier services, etc. This is the marketplace. These business persons are self-employed. Here one more thing that I should add here, the two categories of employment, like one is self-employed and second is employed by others. Here as we talked about Bachu Manji, whether we take example of the hawkers there, you take example of business persons, they all are self-employed. Self-employed means the people, those have their own work. They do not get the work from any other person. And employed by others means the people, those are working under any other person. Like we can take example of workers or helpers. They are in different shops. They are employed by these shop owners. So they are employed by others. But business persons, they are self-employed. Workers in their shops are employed by them. So we can say that these workers or helpers, they are employed by others. The two categories are that. Now, second thing, that here we talked about the people working, selling there on the street. We talked about the people sell the items there in the market. So how we can differentiate them? Like first, if you take example of the person who is selling item there on the street, they buy things from local market. They just get the things and they start, they have the very small business, you can see. They sell there in the streets. But the people, those are working there in the market, they buy things from the bigger towns or manufacturing cities so that they get them at the lower prices and get the high profit. They don't need license to do business. The people, those are selling items there in the street, they do not need to have any license. But the people that are in the market, they need to have the license to do their business. Like we had taken example, the municipal corporation is there who gives the license to different shop owners to start the business. Then the third difference we can take, shops on the street are temporary. There they do not have, they can dismantle that any time. They are not permanent basically. But shops in the market are permanent. So this is how we can differentiate the people who are selling there on the street and the people who are selling there in the market. So this is all about the people that are working there in the street, the people that are in which we had taken different example, the people, the business persons, those are working there, and hawkers that we talked about. I hope that these topics are clear. How do the people in the urban areas get a livelihood? We'll be taking some more topics in next lecture. Now it's time for homework. Question number one, what is being done for hawkers now? Here we talked about the previously hawkers were not allowed to move freely. So that all points will write here. Now the second question it is, which authority issues license to the permanent shops to do business? The authority name you will write here. Question number three, what are the differences between those who sell on the street and those in the market? So all these questions you will do in your fair register. Clear about this? So some more topics, the work they are in the factory and the work in the offices, we will be taking in next lecture. Now it's time for homework solution of lecture 2, chapter 8, geography that was left. What is natural vegetation? The plant like trees, shrubs and grasses which grow on their own without the help from human being are called natural vegetation. Name the different type of vegetation found in India and also write two examples of trees found in each. So five types we had done. Tropical rainforest, important trees found here are mahogany, ebony, rosewood. Tropical deciduous, important trees found here are sal, neem, peepal and shisham. The third it was the thorny bushes, important trees found here are babool, kikar, kher and cactus. Mountain vegetation, important trees found here are chir, pine and devdar. Number five, it was mangrove forest, important trees found here, that is Sundari, that is found there in Sundarban area. The next question, question number three, it was what is the difference between evergreen forest and deciduous forest? Firstly, tropical rainforest, evergreen, that is also known as the tropical rainforest. They are found in the area which receive very heavy rainfall. They are so dense that sunlight does not reach to the ground. They shed their leaves at different times of the year. That is why they are known as the evergreen forest. Important trees found here are mahogany, ebony and rosewood. They are hardwood trees. So this is in the same point we will be taking as we are doing the differentiation. So in the tropical deciduous, these forests are found in large part of our country. Number two, the forests are less dense. They were more dense. They are less dense. Now they shed their leaves at a particular time of the year. They are softwood trees. Important trees found here are sal, neem, peepal and shisham. So in this how you can differentiate evergreen forest and deciduous forest. Question number four it was, why is tropical rainforest also called evergreen forest? They shed their leaves at different times of the year. That's why they always appear green and are known as evergreen forest. So this is all about the homework solution. I hope that the topics of today's lecture you all have understood. Thank you and have a